The July 4th weekend is a moment to celebrate the founding ideals of our republic and how our idea of democracy inspires immigrants to journey toward a new life. Amna Nawaz talks to a British-turned-American author with a unique perspective on what it means to call the U.S. home.
Judy, Roger Bennett is the co-host of the Men in Blazers TV show, but before he became a soccer commentator and an American citizen, he was an 80s kid from Liverpool, England, obsessed with America. From Miami Vice to the Super Bowl shuffle to the Beastie Boys, America represented all the opportunities he felt were out of his reach across the pond. His new book is Reborn in the USA, an Englishman's love letter to his chosen home. Raj, welcome back to the NewsHour. Always good to have you here.
What a way to end this 4th of July weekend, being with you.
So this obsession with all things America, where does it come from?
I grew up in Liverpool in the 1980s. It's a magnificent city, but back then it was in economic decline. The north of England, the coal mines had shut, the steel mills shut down. If you've watched Billy Elliot, you kind of get the drift. And I didn't have ballet dancing in my life, but what I did have was America, American soft power. And as a teen, I inhaled every book, movie, television show, sports star, vinyl LP I could get my hands on. That's how I survived the darkness of Liverpool in the 1980s, that really I was an American trapped in an Englishman's body.
You had some ancestors early in your family who'd also dreamt about coming to the US and never made it. Did that influence your love for America too?
It's actually the gentleman over my shoulder, my great-grandfather Harris. The myth of the Liverpool Jewish community is that they left Ukraine with thousands. He was a butcher headed to Chicago, the hog capital of the world. And when the boat docked to refuel in Liverpool, he saw the one tall building on the Liverpool skyline, thought he was in New York City, and got off the boat thinking he was in the promised land. And so my own grandfather, who I was very close to, whenever things went wrong, he'd pick up a tiny little tchotchke, a Statue of Liberty, from his fireplace and look at it and stare at it and say, oh, we should have lived there. We should have lived there. So I always felt, even though I'd never set foot in America, that was where I was meant to be.
So you spent so much of your childhood just consuming every bit of Americana you could. In the 80s, of course, we mentioned Miami Vice. You grew to love American music, just soaked up everything you could. John Hughes movies you mentioned as well, speaking to you on a very deep level. Why? What was it about those movies and music that spoke to you?
It seems so crazy on the surface, Heart to Heart, The Love Boat, Miami Vice, Moonlighting. But I was enjoying them and imbibing them in the same way. It's like, say, Animal Farm is just a book about horses and pigs. Below the surface, the American color that you received, a life of possibility, a life of joy, a life where you can take your own future into your hands. It was a complete contrast to the black and white in which I grew up with. And that's something that Americans often don't remember about their own nation. When you become American, when you say the oath of allegiance with 162 people from 42 countries, many of whom have escaped civil war or famine or worse to arrive here, all of us were animated by the American idea, that American dream. And that notion of America from afar gives the world such courage, such joy, such tenacity. It saved my life when I needed it and thousands more.
And you tell that story so beautifully in the book about becoming a citizen in 2018. But you also tweeted a photo, I recall, after you became a citizen. A lot of people sent you congratulations notes. You noted in the book, too, that some noted, we're so glad you're an American citizen. Thank you for taking the legal pathway, as it were. As you note in the book, though, you came here in 1993 and you overstayed a tourist visa and then went on to become a citizen. And I wonder how you process that, the sort of reaction you got in becoming a citizen and pursuing American citizenship, as opposed to the ones others people get.
I grew up as a kid with the Statue of Liberty and the Manhattan skyline painted on my bedroom wall, dreaming of living here, and ended up making that absolutely true. And it was the greatest moment of my life to become an American, to swear the oath of allegiance to this country. My whole life has been based around the notion of the American dream. The one I had as a child who had not set foot in the country, it was rich, it was deep, it was built on a perception. It's very different to the American reality. And I still love the American idea more than ever. Now I am here, now I vote, now I have four American kids. But the epigraph of my book is how I square the circle. It's the words of Langston Hughes, the great poet who wrote, "Oh, let America be America again, the land that never has been yet, and yet must be.
Roger, I have to ask you, you spent much of your childhood mass consuming every bit of America you could. Now millions of Americans know you as their gateway to one of England's chief exports, professional soccer. Is there a little bit of irony there? Is that a full circle moment? What's going on?
I love two things in my life. I love football. I'm from Liverpool. It's like high school basketball in Indiana or high school football in Texas. It's how we understand the world. And I also love America. I have to say it's the joy of my life to have seen the sport I love. When I came here and on our show, we joke, soccer, America's sport of the future, as it has been since 1972. But the game now, our women are world champions. And I'll just say our men, they're almost half as good as our women now, which may be good enough to make a lot of noise at the next World Cup. So that future, thank God, is now.
That is Roger Bennett, host of the Men in Blazers show and author of the new book, Reborn in the USA, an Englishman's love letter to his chosen home. Raj, always good to talk to you.
Happy Independence Day to everyone, Judy Woodruff in particular.
And we appreciate that. Roger Bennett, thank you. Love hearing from you.